Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Let's get back to building our application. In this tutorial, we're going to create and register the new app. So we're going to build a new app called Product, and that's going to be our main app that we're going to be working on in this section of the course. Programming is a global practice. Every company that you might work for would have different procedures, different approaches potentially. So you're bound to come across different approaches or different folder structures when developing a Django application. In this project, I've decided to implement a structure whereby all of the applications that we develop will be in within the initial DRF e-commerce folder here, where the settings and our test folder resides. Now, what we could do in actual fact is we could create a folder here and we could call this apps, and then we could put all the apps inside of there. That's another approach that I've seen utilized. But what we're going to do is we're going to use this folder here and add all the apps inside of this folder. So the first app we're going to build is the product app. So we're going to call it product. We're going to create a new folder there. So just thinking about this as a story, what we have here is this outer folder. And all these files here aren't going to be stored in version control necessarily. Maybe the git ignore will be in the git attributes, but generally they haven't really got anything to do with our project. So that's kind of outside of our project, in my opinion. That's how I kind of focus and look at it here. And so you've got some like notes and so on. And then you've got the project folder, which is the DRF commerce folder. So that's my main project folder, right? So inside of here is then everything to do with the project. Now, inside of this folder here, I've got mainly the kind of peripheral type of modules here, manage.py, Pytest INI requirements. So they aren't necessarily anything to do with the actual development as such in terms of how our program works. So that's kind of like the outer area again, where there's some kind of peripheral type of files. So everything now then is stored in this one folder. Anything that we develop will be inside of here. So that's kind of like the rationale here. So everything will be inside of here, including my settings now in the tests and now any of the applications. So like I said, you may have a folder here called apps and then put apps inside of it. And you could nest it like that. But we're going to take the approach of having the actual Django apps inside of this folder. So everything is nicely contained in this one folder. So because we're not going to be utilizing the default path, if you like, where we typically create Django apps, we have gone ahead and create a new folder first. Right, so now we can go ahead and create a new app. So Python 3 or just manage.py, whichever way you want to work. And then let's start a new app. And we need to call that app product. And then we just need to tell Django where we want to put that product app. So that's going to be in DRF, e-commerce, and then product. There we go. Right, so you can now see if we look into the product app here, everything has now been populated. So Django has created the app files for us. Now we can get rid of some of these. Say, for example, the testing file, we're not going to need that because everything is going to be in our testing folder here. And yeah, everything else can stay for now. So that's going to be our new product app. Now what we can also do inside of our tests here, let's go ahead and create a new folder. Now I'm going to call this folder product just to kind of match up the product app. So all the tests related to the product will be in this folder. Now, like I mentioned, when we set up this testing folder, typically you would find the tests inside of closer to the product here or the product app inside of the product app here. And I've just simply made that decision, like I said at the start when we mentioned and looked at creating the testing folder, simply so that everything is just in this one folder. And I think for the purpose of this project and explaining and teaching you these principles, that's going to provide a better experience in terms of kind of navigating to where we need to get to. Now, like I said, you don't need to follow that. And maybe later on in your project, you might want to move that and you may have a different structure for your tests. I think ultimately what I'm trying to say, having spoken a little bit about different approaches, is that ultimately you're going to, if you're working and developing your own app, you're going to have your own approach. And if you're working in a organization, typically they will have an approach that you need to follow, potentially, or your project team will have an approach to follow. So there's no right or wrong way, in my opinion, which way to work. If you've got the benefit of being able to work in your own preferred way, then do that. But if you haven't, then you just need to follow whatever has been set. But I think what's key, and what I've tried to do over different courses, etc., is just to show different approaches to get people familiarized with the idea that there is not one set way of doing something typically. Right, so once we've created our product app here, we're going to need to register this. So to do that, we're going to need to go into our settings, and we're going to go into base, and we're going to just register. This is an internal app, of course, so this is going to be called product. Now, typically, that would be the case. Now, we could just register the app like that. There are different approaches. We're going to use this simplistic approach at this point. So the thing is here, Django won't find that. So it's inside the e-commerce. Because we've created this kind of custom path, if you like, for our apps, we're going to need to tell Django to look in the DRF e-commerce folder here. And inside there, you're going to find the product app here. Now, it's just bad habit, but don't forget, you're going to need a comma. So typically, even if it's the last line, I tend to put a comma because I tend to forget otherwise. So you're going to need some commas there. And then go into the apps file here. And we just need to change the name. And let's change that to DRF e-commerce.product. Okay. So with that done, everything should be fine. We should be able to run our server. So we just double check if you like. Run server. Okay. Everything's looking okay at the moment, although there wouldn't be necessarily much difference if we didn't configure it correctly at this point, but just a little bit of kind of sanity check that everything is working okay at this point.